I'm going to be showing you how to compile two images together in GIMP so that you can create one full image. Say you're scanning photos and you scan one half and then the other. You want to be able to stitch them together, and so this is the process. I'm going to do file open, or not file open. I'm going to do file open as layers, find my two photos. I'm going to use these photos are things I've had on my computer for a while, just one half and then the other. Then I'll hit open, and it should open both of them. Now what you're going to do is make sure you're on your select move tool, and you're going to move them over so that they are overlapping. So you can kind of see, I have to probably zoom in. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit with the zoom tool and then readjust those so they're about on top of each other like that, so the lines match up. Don't worry about the sizing right now. That's not an issue. To zoom, once you're on the zoom tool, you can hold control to zoom out and then just click to zoom in. After that, you're going to go to image and do fit canvas to layers, and it automatically fits your canvas to the size of your images. So after this, you're halfway done pretty much. What you're gonna do is go back to that select tool and select your layers, and you're gonna merge them together, because basically once you merge them, you'll want to be able to fix up some of the art. You can kind of see that this layer here is a little faded, so I'm actually going to erase some of this, and we can create a mask on this layer by right-clicking the layer we want to create a mask and do add layer mask. It'll ask you if you want to do white, black, or invert. We're just going to do a white mask and hit add. Basically, this creates kind of like a blocking out version, so we can take our tool, our paint tool, use the bracket keys to make bigger or smaller, and we're going to be painting with black color, and if we paint, it masks out that area. So this is useful for bringing in that detail again. So I'm going to make my brush as big as possible. You can use a bracket tool, or you can use the sizing over here. And I'm just going to paint in a little bit to see if I can get some of that color back on the character. And then there we go. That's not much, but it's there. You can kind of see it. I might even change the hardness of the brush and adjust some of those settings so that the brush is easier to paint on or paint with. So you can kind of see it's darkening up that area, and I went a little bit too far, so we can actually just change this back to white and recolor that in so that there's no line. Okay, so now that we have them clipped together, we're going to merge them. So we're going to click on this first layer, and then you can see this down here, it says merge this layer, and it merges them together, so now we're on one layer. After that, you want to clean up any lines that are less, that are more noticeable. Like you can kind of see a straight line right here. So I'm going to go in and use my clone tool. So I have the clone tool. I need to control click and not alt click, and then you can clone the movement, so you can kind of see that it starts cloning this line above. This is what the clone tool does. It's used for like cleaning up lines. Say you have a really odd looking seam and you want to cover something up, or say like this line here, we can clone the side and then get rid of that to clean up. So you have still the texture of the paper, but you're cleaning up those areas depending on what you're going to do with your art piece. And make sure you change your source by control clicking so that you're not using the same thing. Because if you continue to leave it on this source and you're trying to mask this out, eventually it's going to start repeating like it's doing here. So that's just something to keep in mind. So we have our image, and you can kind of see there's a line still, so we're going to use that clone tool to clean up some of that line up top. I'm going to make my brush bigger since this is mostly just white. And do control click and start cleaning up, and you can see that white area is becoming less noticeable. It's blending a little bit easier, and we could even use like the blur tool, kind of blur it out. The blur tool doesn't work extremely well, but it does work. And then you can kind of see in the middle here that we have some like lightness to our scene. So we're actually going to duplicate the layer, create this layer as a, we're going to change it to multiply. You can see our lines are darker now, and then we're going to add a layer mask to this multiply layer. We're going to change it to black, and then we're going to paint on our white. So we want this area darker. So you can see it's darker. I'm going to erase that line up top because that's a little too dark. You'll definitely want to play around with this to your liking. And you darkened up those lines, so now if we took that off, see how dark those lines got. So it brings it back into the photo. And you're going to want to keep doing that to, like, say, some of the other lines. This is just only if the lines are very weak in certain areas and you know they're darker in real life. So you can go over some of those lines and just kind of adjust what you need. And then when you're done, you're just going to do file. So you're going to hit the export button after you go to file, find the folder you want to put your image into, and then rename it at the top. After that, you're going to hit the export button and then go and keep the default settings for the export. Okay, and then we're going to hit export. And it's gonna keep exporting in here. And then after that, we can go to our documents and find that picture. And we have our exports, and here we have our combined image. And then obviously it might need some more touching up because you can clearly see this line, but it is useful. You can continue going on and coloring it in digital, that kind of stuff. But this is how you would combine that picture, and we could have even cleaned up this corner right here in that photo easily by just going into our brush and maybe just painting on a little white in that corner. So this would be the process of getting your photos clipped together in GIMP.